What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another impersonated, reputized video. The Intruder was directed by Deon Taylor and stars Meagan Good, Michael Ealy, and Dennis Quaid. And it follows a young married couple who buys a big, beautiful house and land, only to find out that the man they bought it from refuses to let the property go. Going into this, I sort of had a little bit of high expectations, but I knew what I was in for. It's your basic home invasion film, so it's something that we've seen before. Okay, going on with the positives. The story was decent. It was kind of hard whether I wanted to put it in the positives or the negatives, so I'm going to leave it half for now, saying that it was decent, and tell you more about it later, because I want to elaborate a little more on the story. The look and feel, the cinematography and lighting, as I always mention in my videos, I'm so sorry guys, I feel like I repeat myself constantly and I'm trying not to do that. I try not to make y'all feel like you're rewatching the same thing. I try to mix it up, so I apologize for that guys, but it did look good. I think the cinematographer did a really good job on this film. It wasn't too dark or too light. It was just done perfectly. I always gotta throw that out. The edits weren't bad either. Michael Ealy plays Scott Russell, one of the couples that buys the house from this guy. He gave a pretty good performance. The only other movies I remember seeing him in was the first two Barbershop movies and Underworld Awakening, the fourth Underworld. But I know him the best in the first two Barbershop movies. And in this film, as Scott Russell, he did a pretty good job. I believe that he was the only character that actually showed a bit of sense about him. He showed that he had common sense. I'll elaborate on that more on the negatives against one character that I kind of had a problem with later on in this review, but Michael Ealy did a really good job, and I liked his performance. I hope that they cast him in more movies soon, because I think he's a really good actor. Charlie Peck, played by Dennis Quaid, you really, really believe that this guy is mentally disturbed. The way Dennis Quaid played this character, it reminded me a little bit of how the Joker would be, because he smiled a lot in it, and he would make like kind of funny references, but at the same time, not like the Joker, but has a little bit of the ingredients that the Joker would have, like an older Joker. I know that's probably not a good assumption, you know, basing this character on the Joker, one of DC's most top dog villains. I just think that Dennis Quaid brought the type of persona that the Joker would have to this part. That's my assessment, and I'm sticking to it. But yeah, he was really disturbed. He was really psychotic. And by the second act, you try to figure out what the hell is this guy's problem. You sold him the house. Why can't you let it go? The music wasn't bad. It gave it a very eerie vibe, especially when Dennis Quaid's character would show up. Even when he was trying to be nice at first, and he was trying to help out and everything. And then when something would go down, when Michael Ealy's character would be like, back off, get off our property, you'd hear that creepy vibe music in the back, and it's like, oh, crap. Yeah, that's not a good idea. This guy, you don't want to mess with him. And another thing I should warn y'all about, it does touch on a very sensitive subject in today's society. I'm not going to mention what it is, but if you've seen the movie, you'll know what I'm talking about. And it involves Michael Ealy's character. Okay, let's slide into the negatives. Meagan Good plays Annie Russell, the wife. At first, I was into her. As beautiful and cunning as she is, because I do think she's beautiful, I just didn't feel like she had sense about her in this. You know, she had the type of personality that she wanted to help this guy out. She wanted to help Dennis Quaid's character out. I'm not saying that it's not a good idea to be kind to everyone, but you got to pick your battles. If there's one thing that this movie has taught us, not everybody is filled with rainbows and marshmallows and cotton candy. As nice as some people are, you also have to have that common sense about you. You can't go around thinking that everybody deserves help. Everybody is nice. No, that's not how life is. If there's one thing that Dennis Quaid's character in this movie has taught us, is just that. So yeah, Meagan Good's character was kind of getting on my nerves a little bit. Although she did shine a little more in the third act, because she finally got some sense into her. Her husband was the one that kept on telling her something off about this guy. She was like, no, no, I think he's nice. Grow up, girl. Come on. Come on, open your eyes. Meagan Good's bio is pretty long, but I know her the most in Saw 5, and she recently played in a cameo in Shazam. And as I said at the beginning of this review about the story, it was a decent story, but it felt familiar. There are other movies I've seen, I believe one of them is Lakeview Terrence. That one had Samuel L. Jackson in it. I call him Sam Jackson. And that one dealt with a home invasion plotline as well. So did You're Next. And I think so did Unforgettable as well. It felt familiar. It wasn't really that original. You just had this real psychotic guy that had something wrong with him in his mind that was invading this couple at their house. That has been told many times before. It didn't really try to bring anything new to the screen. But what did save it, though, I gotta admit, was Dennis Quaid. I think that he's what shined in this movie. My final thoughts on this film is good to watch only once. If you want to rent it on Redbox or wait until it gets to the Dollar Theater or whatever else, go ahead and do that, but you might as well save your money because it's not nothing big. It's not nothing to hoot and holler about. I'm giving The Intruder a C. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I really do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, get reputized, share. What did you think of The Intruder? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think. Stay tuned for more reviews and videos coming soon to a computer screen or a cell phone near you. Peace, Rip out.